स्टूडेंट्स दिस इज अरविंद असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ट्रिपल डीबीएस आईटी कावली. सो इन द प्रीवियस क्लास आई डिस्कस्ड अबाउट सम ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ शंट कॉम्पनसेशन. लाइक वी हैव फोर ऑब्जेक्टिव्स. वन इज मिड पॉइंट लाइन सेगमेंटेशन एंड नेक्स्ट रेडियल लाइन सेगमेंटेशन एंड इम्प्रूवमेंट ऑफ टेंशन स्टेबिलिटी एंड नेक्स्ट वन इज पावर ऑसिलेशन डैम्पिंग. So now in this class, I'm going to discuss methods of controllable VAT generation. This is very, very important concept in this chapter in the examination point of view. That is methods of controllable VAT generation. So we're coming to the concept that is methods of controllable VAT generation. So actually, we have some devices like capacitors and inductors. So actually these are by definition capacitors generate and reactors absorb reactive power. So actually I said this point so many times in this subject. So by definition capacitors generate and reactors absorb reactive power when connected to an AC power source. Okay, capacitors has to generate reactive power and reactors has to absorb the reactive power when it is connected to an AC power source. So they have been used with mechanical switches for controlled VAT generation. Okay, they have been used with mechanical switches in the past days. Okay, they have been used with the mechanical switches for controlled VAT generation and absorption also. Since the early days of AC power transmission, so controllably variable VAT generation or absorption for dynamic system compensation was originally provided by over or under excited rotating synchronous machines and later by saturating reactors in conjunction with fixed capacitors. So actually if you want to vary the generation by using the continuously varying or absorption for dynamic system compensation was originally provided by over or under excited rotating synchronous machines. So actually in the power system we have to use these synchronous machines. Okay. So and later by saturating reactors in conjunction with the fixed capacitors. Okay, here I am taking the saturating reactors in conjunction with the fixed capacitors. By using these things we have so many methods of controllable VAT generation. Okay, so since the early 1970s high power line commutated thyristors. So high power line commutated thyristors. Okay, line commutated thyristors I already said in the CSC and the objectives of the shunt compensation also. So here the line commutated thyristors in conjunction with capacitors and reactors have been employed in various circuit configurations. Why? Because to produce variable reactive output. So these in effect provide a variable shunt impedance. So these in effect provide a variable shunt impedance by synchronously switching shunt capacitors or reactors in and out of the network. So based on those things, the effect provides a variable shunt impedance. Here I am using a variable shunt impedance by synchronously switching. That means one time we have to use the shunt capacitors and one time we have to use the shunt reactors in and out of the network. Okay. So using appropriate switch control, that means either capacitor or reactors by the switching operations. So using appropriate switch control, the VAR output can be controlled continuously. So the VAR output, that means variable output. Okay, the VAR output can be controlled continuously from maximum capacitive to maximum inductive output at a given bus voltage. This is the main thing we have to do to control the variable output. Okay, continuously. So more recently, gate turn-off thyristors and the other power semiconductors with internal turn-off capability have been used in switching converter circuits. So already I discussed this thing so many times in the previous concepts also. So now onwards, in the present market, we are using the gate turn-off thyristors and the other power semiconductors with internal turn-off capability have been used in switching converter circuits to generate or absorb reactive power without the use of capacitors or reactors. So in the early 1970s, we used capacitors and reactors, okay, to generate or observe the reactive power, but now onwards we are not using these things, and like we use capacitors and reactors for the storing purpose and filtering purpose only. But nowadays there is no use of the capacitors and reactors in the present switching converter circuits. Okay, we are using turn off thyristors or turn off devices or turn off so many semiconductor devices we have which has internal turn off capability. That's why we are using those things instead of capacitors or reactors in the switching converter circuits. Okay, next, so these perform as ideal synchronous compensators. Okay, so those devices perform as ideal synchronous compensators, that means condensers. Okay, why means? In which the magnitude of the internally generated AC voltage is varied to control the wear output. Okay, in which the magnitude of the internally generated AC voltage is varied to control the wear output. So all of the different semiconductor power circuits with their internal controlling enabling them to produce wear output proportional to an input reference to reference and are collectively termed by the joint IEEE and SIGET definitions. We are using the static wear generators, that means SVG. Okay, so all of the different semiconductor power circuits we are using so many power semiconductor devices or circuits, those have internal control capability to enable them to produce wear output proportional to an input reference are collectively termed by the joint IEEE, and those are termed as SVG, static wear generators. So thus a static wear compensator, so actually in the static shunt compensation we are using SVC and STATCOM, mainly SVC and STATCOM. So here SVC, so thus a static wear compensator is by the IEEE SIGET co-definition means a static wear generator whose output is varied so as to maintain or control specific parameters like voltage, current, frequency, like that power. We have some specific parameters, mainly here we are using the voltage and frequency of the electrical power system. Okay, so static wear generator whose output is varied so as to maintain or control specific parameters, that's why we are using the SVC by the definition of the IEEE and SIGET combination. Okay, next, so in the modern static wear generators are based on high power semiconductor switching circuits. Okay, the modern static wear generators are based on high power semiconductor switching circuits. So these switching circuits inherently determine the some of the important operating characteristics. Okay, such as the applied voltage versus obtainable reactive output current. Okay, these are the operating characteristics. We are using some important operating characteristics. Okay, by using those high power semiconductor switching circuits, those are applied voltage versus obtainable reactive output current and harmonic generation and loss versus wear output and attainable response time, setting limits for the achievable performance of the wear generator and independent of external controls used, and ultimately also that of the static wear compensator, SVC. So I will explain these things in the next concepts. Okay, no need to explain those things here. I will explain these things in the next coming classes. Okay, so here I'm going to explain mainly two sections. The following two main sections describe the operating principles and characteristics of two types of static wear generator presently used. So presently we are using so many types. So in those things we have to use mainly two types of static wear generators presently. So those are, so which employ thyristor control reactors. We are using the thyristor control reactors mainly with fixed or thyristor switched capacitors. Okay, reactors with fixed and thyristor switched capacitors, that means TCR and TSC. TCR, shortcutly we will call as TCA, thyristor control reactors as TCR, and the TSC and the thyristor switched capacitors as TSC. Why? Because to realize a variable reactive impedance and those which employ a switching power converter to realize a controllable synchronous voltage source. To realize a controllable synchronous voltage source. So subsequent sections deals with the application requirement structure and operation of external control applicable to both the types of air generator, which define the functional capabilities and operating policies of the compensator under different system conditions. So mainly we will focus on the TCR and TSR with fixed or variable reactive impedances. Okay. Why? Because to realize a controllable synchronous voltage source. And after that, we are going to discuss what are the application requirements we have to use and the structure of that system and operation of the external control and applicable to both types of air generators. Is it applicable to both types of generators or not? Which define the functional capabilities? Those are used to define the functional capabilities and operating of policies of the compensator under different system conditions. Okay. Next, coming to the methods of controllable wire generation, in that one we have firstly variable impedance type static wire generators, variable impedance type static wire generators. So under this we have so many types. That means the performance and operating characteristics of the impedance type wire generators are determined by their major thyristor controlled constituents. That means the thyristor controlled reactor TCR and the thyristor switched capacitor TSC. Okay, by using these things, we have to give the performance and operating characteristics of the impedance type wire generators. Okay, static wire generators. Okay, mainly we have to use the thyristor TCR and TSC. Okay, so these are the different types of methods we have to give the performance and operating characteristics of the impedance type wire generators by using these things. So firstly, I will explain TCR, that is thyristor controlled reactor, and TSR, thyristor switched reactor, and next TSC, that is thyristor switched capacitor, and next I am going to discuss fixed capacitor thyristor controlled reactor type wire generator, that is fixed capacitor TCR type wire generator, TCR, and TSC and TCR type wire generator, TSC and TCR type. Okay, that means thyristor switched capacitor and thyristor controlled reactor type wire generators. Okay, firstly I will explain the TCR and TSR. TCR and TSR. In this class I am going to discuss this TCR and TSR, that means thyristor controlled reactor and thyristor switched reactor. So here I am taking one diagram. So this diagram gives the single phase thyristor controlled reactor, single phase thyristor controlled reactor. Okay, so it consists of two thyristors in parallel connection and one inductor. It is in series with this connection. Okay, so here one thyristor will act as a switch. Okay, and the inductor consists of the IL of alpha. Okay, I will explain this operation in the next slide. So actually the TCR, that means thyristor controlled reactor, consists of fixed reactor of inductance L, that is the reactor symbol we have, that is the inductor. So it consists of a fixed reactor of inductance, usually air core inductor, okay, air core inductor, and a bidirectional thyristor valve, bidirectional thyristor valve. This is also known as switch. Here I am using that as switch, bidirectional thyristor valve or switch. Actually, we have currently available large thyristors can block voltage up to 4000 to 9000 volts. Currently available large thyristors can block voltage up to 4000 to 9000 volts and conduct current up to 3000 to 6000 amperes. Okay, thus in practical valve, many thyristors, that means typically 10 to 20 thyristors, are connected in series to meet the required blocking voltage levels, that means 4000 to 9000 volts. To meet the required blocking voltage levels at a given power rating. Okay, so in the practical, we have to use the 10 to 20 thyristors. That too is connected in series to meet the required blocking voltage levels at a given power rating. So a thyristor valve can be brought into conduction by simultaneous application of gate pulse to all thyristors of the same polarity. Okay, note this one. A thyristor valve can be brought into conduction by simultaneous application of a gate pulse to all thyristors of the same polarity. So here the valve will automatically block immediately after the AC current crosses zero. Okay, the valve will automatically block immediately after the AC current crosses zero unless the gate signal is reapplied. Okay, unless the gate signal is reapplied. And next, so the current in the reactor, that means inductor, can be controlled from maximum to zero. So maximum means when the thyristor valve is closed, and zero means when the thyristor valve is open, by the method of firing delay angle control. Okay, by using firing delay angle control. Okay, next, that is the closure of the thyristor valve is delayed with respect to the peak of the applied voltage in each half cycle. So actually I said this point in the previous class also. So the closure of the thyristor valve is delayed with respect to the peak of the applied voltage in each half cycle, and thus the duration of the current conduction intervals is controlled. Duration of the current conduction intervals is controlled because of the delay. Okay. And next, this method of current control is illustrated separately for the positive and negative half cycles. Okay. This method, that means TCR, thyristor control reactor. So this method of current control is illustrated separately for the positive and negative current half cycles in the next diagram. I will show the diagram. So where the applied voltage V and the reactor current IL of A, or IL of alpha, sorry, it is a mistake. There is a mistake there. That is not IL of A, that is IL of alpha, delay angle. That is alpha is the delay angle at zero delay angle, which that means fully closed condition, and at an arbitrary a delay angle are shown. And an arbitrary delay angle are shown. I will show the diagram. So this one. Okay. So this one gives the method of current control is illustrated separately for the positive and negative half cycle, current half cycle. So here I am taking two. So one is for positive half cycle and another is for negative half cycle. Okay. Next, the two current. Okay, positive and negative current half cycles. So here applied voltage V and reactive current at zero delay angle and at an arbitrary delay angle. So zero delay angle and arbitrary delay angle. So the waveforms is like this. So here I drawn a three curves. On the left side, if you see this one, so here I am drawing a curve between, characteristic curve between omega t versus voltage, and it consists of the current at alpha is equal to zero and at alpha and at sigma also. So on the negative half cycle, we have the value that is minus V by omega L sine alpha. And at the positive half cycle, we have the value that is V by omega L sine alpha. So at that time in the negative half cycle, we have IL of alpha is equal to zero. And at IL of alpha, we have the curves and the voltage curves also there. So here we have the three curves. One is for the voltage and another two is for the inductor current values. Inductor current values at delay angle alpha. That two at zero and at some value. Okay. So these are the two waveforms for the positive and negative half cycles of current. Okay. And next, so when alpha is equal to zero, that means when the delay angle is zero, the valve switch closes. So this is important to note. So when alpha is equal to zero, the valve, that is a bidirectional switch is there. We are using the thyristors. So when alpha is equal to zero, the valve switch closes at the crest of the applied voltage, at the crest of the applied voltage. And evidently the resulting current in the reactor, okay, the resulting current in the reactor will be the same as that obtained in steady state with a permanently closed switch. Okay, so the reactor, the resulting current in the reactor will be the same. Okay, next, this method of current control is illustrated separately for the positive and negative cycles. I already said this point and already shown these diagrams where the applied voltage V and the reactive current IL of alpha at zero delay angle at an arbitrary alpha delay angle are shown. But when the gating of the valve is delayed, when the gating of the valve is delayed by an angle alpha, that is zero less than alpha less than pi by 2, that means alpha is lies between 0 to pi by 2. The delay angle lies between 0 to pi by 2 with respect to the crest of the voltage. The current in the reactor can be expressed with V of t is equal to V cos omega t. So that is as follows. So here, that is IL of t is equal to, that means the reactive current is equal to 1 by L integral 0 to omega t V of t dt. So here V of t is equal to V cos omega t. So V of t is equal to V cos omega t, substitute in the place of V of t and apply the integration to the V cos omega t. So from that one we are writing V by omega L into sin omega t minus sin alpha. After simplifying that one, we have this equation, that is V by omega L into sin of omega t minus sin alpha. So since the thyristor valve by definition opens as the current reaches zero, so I already said this point in the previous slides. So since the thyristor valve by definition opens as the current reaches zero, so that's why I am taking this equation IL of t is equal to V by omega L into sin omega t minus sin alpha is valid for the interval at omega alpha is less than omega t is less than sin pi minus alpha, is valid for the interval when the omega t is less between alpha to pi minus alpha. So for subsequent past to half cycle intervals, the same expression obviously remains valid. The same expression means that is IL of t is equal to V by omega L into sin omega t minus sin alpha. So for subsequent negative half cycle intervals, the sign of the terms is becomes opposite. The sign of the same expression will be becomes opposite. That means that is from the equation, that is IL of t is equal to V by omega L into sin omega t minus sin alpha. The term V by omega L into sin alpha is simply an alpha dependent constant. So the term V by omega L into sin alpha is simply an alpha dependent constant by which the sinusoidal current obtained at alpha is equal to zero is offset, shifted down for positive and up for negative current half cycles as illustrated in the next diagram. I will show the diagram. It will give the clarity about this explanation. Okay. So here I am showing a diagram which consists of positive and negative current half cycles in the same. Okay. So this is the diagram. These are the operating waveforms at from alpha is equal to 0 to alpha is equal to alpha 4 at IL of alpha and VL of alpha. Here we have two curves. One is for the inductor current at a delay angle alpha and VLF of alpha, that is the voltage at delay angle alpha. Okay. So here the angle is varied between alpha is equal to 0 to alpha 4 at different intervals. Okay. So in the negative half cycle, so this one. So this is for positive half cycle and this is for negative half cycle. Okay. So shifted down for positive and up for negative half cycles as illustrated in the previous diagram. That means this diagram. Okay. And next. So since the valve automatically turns off at the instant of current zero crossing, so this process actually controls the conduction interval. So this process actually controls the conduction interval of the thyristor valve. That means conduction interval is nothing but the angle, delay angle. Controls the conduction interval of the thyristor valve. So that is the delay angle alpha. So here also mistake is there. So that is the delay angle alpha defines the prevailing conduction angle sigma. Okay. That is the delay angle alpha defines the prevailing conduction angle alpha in the form of sigma is equal to pi minus 2 alpha, pi minus 2 alpha. Thus, as the delay angle alpha increases, as the delay angle alpha increases, the correspondingly increasing offset results in the reduction of the conduction angle sigma of the valve and consequent reduction of the reactor current. That means if the delay angle alpha increases, the corresponding increasing offset results in the reduction of the conduction angle sigma of the valve and the consequent reduction of the reactor current. That means if the angle is increases, alpha increases, means there is a reduction in the conduction angle sigma, that is pi minus 2 alpha, and the consequent reduction of the reactor current, that is IL of alpha. IL of alpha. So at the maximum delay of alpha is equal to pi by 2, the offset also reaches its maximum of V by omega L. Okay, at the maximum delay of alpha is equal to pi by 2, the offset also reaches its maximum of V by omega L at which both the conduction angle and the reactor current becomes zero. Conduction angle and the reactor current becomes zero. Next, so we should note that the two parameters, that is the delay angle alpha and delay angle sigma and conduction angle alpha, are equivalent, and therefore the TCR can be characterized by either of them. That means their use is simply a matter of preference. That means for this reason, that means expressions related to the TCR, the expressions related to the TCR, that is thyristor controlled reactor, can be found in the literature, both in terms of alpha and sigma, So from this one, it is evident that the magnitude of the current in the reactor can be varied continuously by this method of delay angle control, from maximum, that means alpha is equal to 0, to 0, that means alpha is equal to pi by 2. Alpha is equal to pi by 2. So next, I will show the diagram. It will explain this maximum to 0 values of the delay angle control, okay, of the current in the reactor can be varied continuously by using these things. So this is the waveform. This is also known as operating waveforms of the operation. Okay, so it will explain at different delay angles how the reactor current varies continuously. So at alpha is equal to 0, normal. At alpha is equal to alpha 1, some change is there in the waveforms. Okay, at alpha is equal to alpha 2, one more change. That means alpha is equal to alpha 1, the change is in on the negative half circle. At alpha is equal to alpha 2, the change going to the positive half circle. And at alpha is equal to alpha 3, again it comes to the negative half circle. At alpha is equal to alpha 4, it comes to again positive side. So these are the various operating waveforms of the continuously varying the reactor current at the crest of the operating voltage V. Okay. Next, so here where the reactor current, that is IL of alpha, together with its fundamental current component, that is ILF of alpha, are shown at various delay angles alpha. Okay, so note that, however, that the adjustment of current in the reactor, okay, the adjustment of current in the reactor can take place only once in each half cycle, that is in the 0 to pi by 2 interval. That is in the 0 to pi by 2 interval, that is alpha is equal to 0, that is the closed condition, alpha is equal to pi by 2, that is the open condition, that is maximum to 0, 0 to maximum we have. So these are also known as gating or firing intervals. So this restriction results in a delay of the attainable current control. And the worst case delay when changing the current from maximum to zero or vice versa, okay, is a half cycle of the applied AC voltage. That is the worst case delay. And the amplitude of ILF of alpha of the fundamental reactor current, that is ILF of alpha, can be expressed as a function of angle alpha, that is ILF of alpha, okay, is equal to V by omega L into 1 minus 2 by pi into alpha minus 1 by pi sine 2 alpha. This is treated as equation number 5.5a according to this. ILF of alpha is equal to V by omega L into 1 minus 2 by pi alpha minus 1 by pi sine 2 alpha. Okay. Next, so where V is the amplitude of the AC voltage, from this equation I am taking, that is V is amplitude of the voltage, applied AC voltage, and L is the inductance of the thyristor controlled reactor, and omega is the angular frequency from the equation. V by omega L into 1 minus 1 by pi sine alpha minus 1 minus 1 by 2, 1 by pi sine 2 alpha. Okay. So where the V is the amplitude of the applied AC voltage, and L is the inductance of the thyristor controlled reactor, and omega is the angular frequency of the applied voltage, and the variation of the amplitude, that is ILF of alpha, normalized to the maximum current ILF of maximum, at ILF of maximum is equal to V by omega L, is shown and plotted against the delay angle alpha in the figure. I will show the diagram in the next. So this is the diagram. So here I am taking the amplitude variation of the fundamental TCR current, that is thyristor controlled reactor current, with the delay angle alpha. So here I am taking the angle between 0 to 90 degrees, that is alpha is equal to 0 to 90, and I am taking the current values from 0 to 1, that too in the per units. Okay, this is the circuit diagram for that one, for the TCA, that is the thyristor control reactor. So it consists of a two thyristors connected in parallelity. These thyristors will act as a switch. Okay, and it consists of a fixed reactor. Okay, it consists of the current ILF of alpha. So here we have, at alpha is equal to 90 degrees, we have this curve. Okay, this one is also called a parabola. Okay, parabola. And these dotted lines gives 1 minus 2 by pi alpha and 1 minus 1 by pi sin 2 alpha. Actually, the ILF of alpha is equal to V by omega L into 1 minus 2 by pi alpha. So 1 minus 2 by pi alpha is gives from the this horizontal, this is parallel line drawn to the ILF of alpha line. And next, one more curve is there. This curve is drawn between ILF of alpha at 1 to alpha is equal to 90 degrees, that is 1 minus pi sin 2 alpha. Okay, so this curve, half sine curve is the dotted lines. This one 1 minus pi, 1 minus 1 by pi sin 2 alpha. Okay, this is the amplitude variation of the fundamental TCAR current with the delay angle alpha. Okay, so from this one, it is clear that the TCAR can control the fundamental current continuously from 0 to a maximum value, that is valve open to valve close, as if it was a variable reactive admittance, as if it was a variable reactive admittance. And next, thus an effective reactive admittance, that is BLF of alpha for the TCR, can be defined as, so the this admittance as a function of angle alpha, that is BLF of alpha is equal to 1 by omega L into 1 minus 2 by pi alpha minus 1 by pi sin 2 alpha. So here we are not considering the voltage. Okay. This is the effective reactive admittance for the TCR. Okay. With a function of angle alpha. That is BLF of alpha is equal to 1 by omega L into 1 minus 2 by pi alpha minus 1 by pi sin 2 alpha. This is treated as equation number 5.5b. So eventually the admittance, that is BLF of alpha, varies with alpha in the same. Alpha, not A. So with alpha in the same manner as the fundamental current ILF of alpha. Okay. Next, the meaning of this equation is that at each delay angle alpha, an effective admittance BLF of alpha can be defined, which determines the magnitude of the fundamental current. This determines the magnitude of the fundamental current, that is ILF of alpha, in the TCR at a given applied voltage V. In the TCR, that is the thyristor control reactor, at a given applied voltage V. And so in practice, the maximal magnitude of the applied voltage and that of the corresponding current will be limited by the ratings of the power components, that is reactor and thyristor valves used. Okay, so actually in the practice, the maximum amplitude magnitude of the applied voltage, that is V, and that of the corresponding current will be limited by the ratings of the power components, that is reactor and thyristor valve, of the power components used. So thus a practical TCR can be operated anywhere in a defined VI area, that is voltage current characteristic area, so the boundaries of which are determined by its maximum attainable admittance, that means voltage and current ratings, as illustrated in the diagram. So this is the diagram. So this is the operating voltage current characteristics area of the TCR, that is in the right, left side of the diagram A, and B is the TSR, that is the thyristor switched reactor diagram. These are the operating VI area of the TCR and TSR. So left side we have the TCR diagram and on the right side we have the TSR diagram. Okay. So the TCR limits are established by the design from actual operating requirements. So the TCR limits are established by design from actual operating requirements. So if the TCR switching is restricted to a fixed delay angle, TCR means, you know, thyristor controlled reactor switching is restricted to a fixed delay angle, usually at alpha is equal to 0, that is the fixed delay angle, then it becomes a thyristor switched reactor, that is TSR. So that means if the thyristor controlled reactor switching is restricted to a fixed delay angle, that is alpha is equal to 0, then it becomes a thyristor switched reactor, that is TSR. That is TSR. So the TSR provides a fixed inductive admittance. So the TSR also provides fixed inductive admittance, and thus when connected to the AC system, the reactive current in it will be proportional to the applied voltage, as the VI plot in the figure B indicates. On the right side of the diagram, you note this one. Okay. Next, several TSRs can provide a reactive admittance controllable in a step-like manner. That is, if the TSRs are operated at alpha is equal to 0, the resultant steady state current will be sinusoidal. The resultant steady state current will be sinusoidal. Now, next, inspection of the previous diagram shows that, that is, this diagram, I will show that one again. So, by the inspection of this diagram, so this diagram consists of both positive and negative half cycles. On the left side, we have the positive half cycle, and in the right side, we have the negative half cycle of the TCR operation. Okay, so by inspecting that waveform shows that the conduction angle control characterizing the operation of the TSR results in a non-sinusoidal current waveform in the reactor. Okay, by the inspection of the diagram shows that the conduction angle control characterizing the operation of the TCR results in a non-sinusoidal current waveform in the reactor. Okay, next, so these are the operating voltage current area of the TCR and TSR. So if you observe this diagram, we have drawn a curve between IL, that is the inductor current versus terminal voltage or thyristor voltage. Okay, it consists of a BL maximum. So here the BL maximum is the maximum admittance of the TCR. Maximum admittance of the TCR. That is the TCR means thyristor controlled reactor. So here the curve is a constant straight line. That means it is increasing manner. So and I take a dotted line, it indicates the maximum voltage limit of the inductor. Okay, so I indicate it with the cross lines. Okay, so on the right side we have one more diagram. So it gives the operating VI area of the TSR. Okay, so here also I am drawing a curve between inductor current IL and VT, that is a thyristor voltage. Okay, so here also the line is a straight line but in an increasing manner. Okay, so here I am indicating VL maximum and IL maximum. So here I am taking BL, that is the admittance of reactor. Okay, so this is the operating VI area of TCR and TSR. And next, this is the inspection area. So by using this curve, we determine this VI characteristics. Okay. And next, so in the other words, the thyristor controlled reactor, that is TCR, in addition to the wanted fundamental current, also generates harmonics. Up to now, we discussed about the operation of those TCR and TSR. And now I'm coming to the harmonics concept. So for the both TCR and TSR. So in other words, the thyristor controlled reactor, that is TCR, in addition to the wanted fundamental current, also generates harmonics. So for ideal positive and negative half cycles, only odd harmonics are generated. Only odd harmonics are generated. So the amplitudes of these are a function of angle alpha as expressed by the following equation, that is I ln of alpha is equal to V by omega L into 4 by pi into sin alpha cos n alpha minus n cos alpha sin n alpha by n into n square minus 1, where n is equal to 2k plus 1 and k is equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on. Okay, this is the amplitude of the area of angle alpha. This is the expressed in the equation, that is I ln of alpha is equal to V by omega L into 4 by pi into sin alpha cos n alpha minus n cos alpha sin n alpha by n into n square minus 1. Next, so the amplitude variation of the harmonics, okay, the amplitude variation of the harmonics expressed as percentage of the maximum fundamental current. That is also shown. I will show the diagram. So this one. So this is the amplitudes of the harmonic components in the current of the TCR versus the delay angle alpha. So here the curve is drawn between delay angle alpha and IN. Okay. Harmonic components in the current. So this is the circuit arrangement for this one, and this is the curves for the supplied voltage and inductor current ILF alpha. Okay. So here, so it gives the amplitude variation of the harmonics expressed as percentage of the maximum fundamental current that is plotted in this diagram. So this one, and so in a three phase system, three single phase thyristor controlled reactors are used. So you know already this one. So in a three phase system, three single phase thyristor controlled reactors are used, usually in delta connection. Okay. So under balanced conditions, the triple N harmonic currents, that is 3rd, 9th, 15th, that is 3 into 1, 3, 3 into 3, 9, 3 into 5, 15, like that we have the triple N harmonic currents. These harmonic currents circulate in the delta connected TCRs and do not enter the power system. So these triple N harmonics do not enter into the power system. These are only circulated in the delta connected TCRs only. And the magnitudes of the other harmonics generated by the TCRs can be reduced by various methods. I will give those methods also. Okay, the magnitudes of the other harmonics generated by the thyristor controlled reactors can be reduced by the various methods. So this is the curve. So here I am taking I3, I9 and I5, I7 and I1 like that. So I3, I9 curves gives the, these are absent for three phase balanced systems, and I5, I7 are absent for the 12 pulse current arrangements. Okay, I3 and I9 are absent for the three phase balanced systems, and I5 and I7 are absent for the 12 pulse current arrangements. Here we are using I7 and I9 and I11, I13 and I5 and I1 also, and I3. So like that we are using the curves. So here the first curve is drawn between 0 to 80 degrees. So the curve is like a half sine wave. Okay. And next we have different curves for the I5, I7, I9, I11. These are the amplitudes of the harmonic components in the currents of the TCR. These are the harmonic components we have for this diagram in the percentages. Okay, next. So I already said that we are using different methods to reduce these thyristor controlled reactors harmonics generated by this TCRs. The magnitudes of the other harmonic generators is reduced by different methods. One method is particularly advantageous for high power applications. These imply M of M greater than or equal to 2 parallel connected TCRs, each with 1 by M of that the total rating required. Next, the reactors are sequentially controlled. That is, only one of the M reactors is delay angle controlled, and each of the remaining M minus 1 reactors is either fully on or fully off, depending upon the total reactive power required. So, as illustrated for 4 reactors, I will show the diagram also. So these are used for the sequentially controlling of the reactors when the delay angle is controlled by using delay angle control. So this is, here I am using four reactors. Okay, 4 reactors with the corresponding switch connection, switch 1, switch 2, switch 3 and switch 4. And it consists of the total current, that is IL1 plus IL2 plus IL3 plus IL4. And we have some waveforms for the illustrating the method of controlling 4 TCR banks sequentially. Why? Because to achieve harmonic reduction. So in the first diagram, here I am taking the cycles, that is 5 cycles, and it consists of the inductor currents, that is 0.25 to 0 to 1. It is between 0.25 and 0.5, 0.75 and 1. So here the curve is like this. One up to 0.75 we have a straight line, and after that we have decrease in the this operation, that is the current. And next we are draw the currents between the current waveforms of the IL1, IL2, IL3 and IL4, the current flowing in the inductors 1, 2, 3, 4. We have these curves, and corresponding voltage waveforms is also there. And lastly we have the total current. That is IL total is equal to IL 1 plus IL 2 plus IL 3 plus IL 4. These are the waveforms for this operation. Okay. And next, so in this way, the amplitude of every harmonic is reduced by the factor m with respect to the maximum rated fundamental current. Like this way, we are decreasing the harmonics by using the factor m with respect to the maximum rated fundamental current. That is ILF of maximum, alpha maximum. The next, furthermore, losses associated with this scheme are generally lower than those characterizing a TCR with equivalent rating due to the reduction in switching losses. So here the losses associated with this scheme are generally lower than the those characterized a TCR with rating due to the reduction in switching losses. So another method employs a 12 pulse TCR arrangement. So that is one method. Up to now we discussed one method of reduction of harmonics in the TCR. And next, another method employs a 12 pulse TCR arrangement. So in this, two identical three-phase delta connected thyristor controlled reactors are used. In this one, two identical three-phase delta connected thyristor controlled reactors are used. One operated from star connected windings, the other from delta connected windings of the secondary of a coupling transformer. So here we are used another types also, other types of transformer arrangements, those providing two sets of three-phase voltages with 30 degree phase shift. Okay, those are also will be used. Okay, so because of the 30 degree phase shift between the related voltages of the two transformer windings, the 5th, 7th, 17th and 19th, generally the harmonic currents of order 6 into 2k minus 1 minus 1 and 6 of 2k minus 1 plus 1, where k is equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on, and cancel, resulting in a nearly sinusoidal output current at all delay angles are illustrated by the current waveforms in the diagram. So this is the diagram. So here I am taking 12 pulse arrangement of two sets of thyristor controlled reactors. So here I am using two sets of arrangements, thyristor controlled reactors, okay. So, and associated current waveforms on the left right side. So this is the connection diagram for the 12 pulse arrangement. So here I am taking two 6 pulse converters, two sets of thyristor controlled reactors. So one is with the delta connection and one is with the star connection, okay. This is the 12 pulse TCR arrangement, okay, and these are the corresponding waveforms of that one. So here the current waveforms is like this. So here we have I1, I2, I3, I4, IL4, IL, I34 and I24, and INY, I3Y and I2Y, and IL12 delta, IL23 delta and IL31 delta, and IL12 star and IL23 star and IL31 star. Like that we have different waveforms for this 12 pulse TCR arrangement. Okay. Next, so further harmonic cancellation is possible by operating three or more delta connected TCRs from appropriately phase shifted voltage sets. Okay, further harmonic cancellation is possible by operating three or more delta connected TCRs. So up to now we discussed two or more connections, that is for the 12 pulse TCR operation, and now we are increasing that. We are using the harmonic cancellation is possible by operating three or more delta connected TCRs from appropriately phase shifted voltage sets. So in practice, however, these 18 and higher pulse circuit arrangements tend to be too complex and expensive. Okay, so up to 12 pulse we have normal, but after that, if you want to increase that to next further level, there is a tendency in the system that it is too complex to operate, and these circuits are also expensive. So also it becomes increasingly difficult to meet the requirements for symmetry due to possible unbalance in the AC system voltages to achieve significant reduction in the amplitudes of higher order harmonics. Okay. Next, so for these reasons, higher than 12 pulse circuit configurations are seldom used. Okay, next, I want to note that, so the statement generally applies only to line commutator circuits employing conventional thyristors only, not self-commutator circuits. It is for the line commutator circuits, and the output voltage waveform construction of the self-commutator power circuits is largely independent of the AC system voltages, and a high typically 48 or 24 pulse voltage source converter structures have been used in all existing high power compensator installations. Okay. Next, if the TCR generated hormones cannot be reduced sufficiently by circuit arrangements such as four reactor system that is shown in the diagram or the 12 pulse structure in the diagram to meet specification requirements for economic or practical reasons, which often case harmonic filters are employed. Okay, and next. So normally these filters are series LC and LCR branches in parallel with TCR. LC means inductor capacitor and LCR means inductor capacitor reactor branches in parallel with the TCR and are tuned to the dominant harmonics such as the 5th, 7th and occasionally the 11th and 13th, usually with an additional high pass branch. So the high pass filter is sometimes implemented by shunting the reactor of one of the LC filter branches with a resistor in order to maintain reasonable attenuation at higher frequencies where tuned filters are not effective. Okay. Next, in many practical applications, due to unbalances, resonant conditions in the AC system network are independent control of the three TCRs, that means the single phase, and a tuned filter branch at the third harmonic frequency may also be required. So these are the methods of controllable wire generation in case of by using the TCR and TSR in this arrangement, and harmonic components and the reduction techniques of this TCR and TSR explained. And in the next class, I'm going to discuss remaining methods. Okay, thank you.